So I hope you don't mind, but I have to call my sister. So she's been begging me like all the time. She's like, I want to see one of your shows, and she doesn't live here. She lives in Nebraska. So she was like joking around today. She's like, just call me during your show. Okay. So
I'm gonna.
Her name's Lana. I'm gonna get her on speakerphone.
Is this real?
Yeah, this is happening.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Hello? Yes. Hey, what are you doing?
Playing with that.
Cool. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
You're on stage, Lana.
All right.
Yay!
Lady, can you do that? Can you just yell out, what's up, Camp Bar? Yell it out.
I can't hear you.
Yell out really loud. Yell, what's up, Camp Bar?
What's up, Camp Bar?
Okay, so I'm gonna leave her on speakerphone so she can hear this set. Can you hear me still, Lana?
A little bit, yeah.
She can hear me. Alright, so here's...
It sounds like you're in a cave.
Oh.
You killed me! You killed
me! I dropped you!
You killed me!
Oh no, but it's on the camera now. Take your pictures. Are you still there? Are you still there? Cool. Okay. Alright. This is gonna work, I think. I don't know if you can believe it, but the first time I did stand-up, I won a contest.
Which one?
I mean, yeah, it was a hot dog eating contest. But gave me a lot of confidence. I went to the doctor the other day. I had a sore throat, and I was diagnosed with severe depression. But the doc, they ask loaded questions. They're like, how are you? Duh, I'm shitty, I'm at the doctor. Do you ever have suicidal thoughts? Well, no, but I'm considering murder right now, highly. Like, just stop it. So they give me a quiz, and I nailed it. Nailed it. It was, you know, a depression quiz, 10 questions, easiest thing I've ever taken. And, but the weird thing is that it was very eerily similar to the Scientology quiz, like the quiz that you have to, anyone ever done that?
Yep.
Yeah? I went to the Scientology church and I took the personality quiz there. The only difference between that and the depression quiz is that the Scientology quiz is 200 questions. But I did it because I'm invested in my spiritual journey, guys. And then, like, they want you to be depressed. At least the doctor's, like, rooting for you not to be, but the Scientologists, that's what they want. They're like, we hope she's really fucking depressed, and even if she's not, we're gonna tell her that she is. And then tell her to pay all this money to buy these books and do the program. That's what they want. I'm not a Scientologist, but I have been trying to do things that are gonna, like, better my life and stuff. Things change when you're 30, when you're in your 30s. It gets different. Like, I used to be able to drink hard liquor, and now I just can't. It makes me sick. But I like to do fun things in life, though, that makes it so that I'm still having a good time. Like, every morning, I take all of my vitamins out of a shot glass. So, having a good time. I think of most of my jokes when I'm in the shower. I guess it's a good place to think of stuff. I think of things better when I'm wet and slippery, I guess. It's like the reason that I'm so passionate about Jell-O wrestling. I've been dating, and I tried the online thing, and it's not really working for me. I just kind of want to meet a man in the wild, you know? So lately I've been standing outside my apartment, and I'll yell things like, I'm free most nights. This is how I look. But like the truth is, guys, I'm free all night. I just, like, you gotta leave some mystery. Can't give it all away right up front. Dating's hard because it's really difficult for me to find a guy who's good enough for my dad. My dad, I'm from Western South Dakota. He's an actual cowboy, guys. Like, my dad is what all little boys want to be when they grow up. He's really a cowboy. And it's so hard to find a guy who my dad's going to approve of. Like, when I was in college this one time, I brought a guy home, a boyfriend from college. I took him home to meet my family. We get there, and my dad immediately didn't like the guy because he's a city slicker. He's like, I hate this guy. So he's like, we have these calves, these steer calves in the corral who need to be castrated. There's like three of them. He takes my boyfriend, we go out to the corral. He makes my boyfriend like hold down the calf while he castrates them. And then takes the testicles and bring them in the house and we skin them up and cook them and eat them for dinner. So he makes my boyfriend eat the testicles of an animal that he watched him skin, castrate earlier that day. It's a delicacy out there, so to give my dad some credit. But what I'm trying to say is that I'm single. My sister told me that's a true story. She's saying, true story.
Yeah, tell her.
So dating's not that great for me. I decided maybe I should get into porn. So, or not like do it, but start watching porn instead of dating. And so I remember the first time I watched porn, like it was yesterday. It was yesterday. So I went to my computer and I didn't know what to do. So I just put in the Google search, I put porn, and then like internet exploded. Because you have to be really specific when you're searching porn. You have to put in things like
ivory porn.
Like hair seven beings porn or lesbians in space. Which is my favorite kind.
Mine too.
Actually, it's not my favorite. My favorite kind of porn, I found out, like, well, I had to do a lot of research. So I did a lot of research, and by research I mean that I stared at my computer like this for like 2 hours, and it scared my vagina. My vagina was like, you're not gonna do that to me, are you? I was like, calm down, Betsy. Calm down. I know what you're thinking. Why would she name her vagina for my grandmother? Well, she's a prude, and the resemblance is uncanny. But I did finally figure out what my favorite kind of porn is, and it's old-timey porn. You know, like black and white silent film stuff. It's classier. But I don't know, I think it's kind of going to ruin me for dating, because now I just get really pissed every time my dates don't start with a tea party and end with a tap dance. All right, that's all I got for you tonight.